It says in our Haggadah, the book that we use to guide our ritual around our Passover Seder table, that we are commanded in every generation that each and every one of us, it is incumbent upon us to see ourselves as having been personally liberated from Mitzrayim, personally liberated from Egypt. We don't just imagine, we remember. We don't just reenact, we uncover. Each year as we sit around our Passover Seder, we are commanded to remember our own experience of liberation from Egypt in ancient times, or from our contemporary Mitzrayim, our contemporary narrowness. But perhaps it is not just a call to memory, because memory is not always something that is sort of stationary, right? Memory not only allows us to recall our own experiences, but memory also breeds empathy. When we remember our own experience, the experience of our ancestors, the experience of ourselves, the experience of our parents, the experience that we hope our children will have the resilience to move through, we also cultivate empathy. Empathy with those who are still in Mitzrayim. Empathy with those around our tables who are fighting the narrowness, who are stuck in those places where systemic oppression, in whatever context they are living, is an experience of Mitzrayim. We don't just hear their stories and nod, we hear their stories and remember our own. And it moves us to action and to allyship. And for those of us who are in a moment of Mitzrayim, of narrowness, we don't just remember. We remember that Mitzrayim and we connect that to our own personal moment. Because at the end of that Mitzrayim comes liberation. Comes a moment where we stood at the shores of a sea, unsure what the path ahead would look like. And as the sea parted, as Moses raised his staff, or as Nachshon ben Aminadav began to wander in, or as whatever that moment actually looked like in our mythic past, we tap into our present. Because in our present Mitzrayim, whatever that may look like for us right now, there may not be a clear road ahead. But as we remember around our Seder table each and every year, it gives us hope, because at the end of that Mitzrayim was liberation, that so too will there be liberation at the end of our own contemporary Mitzrayim. If we have the faith, if we have the strength to work for it, if we have the courage to be the one to wade in, or the one to hold the hand and support the one who is wading in. And as we sing Michamocha, the song of that moment of liberation, we raise all of that up. We raise it up in our hearts, and we raise it up as we prepare to carry it into our Passover Seder. Michamocha,